Good morning for those of us on the West Coast. Good afternoon for those of us on the East Coast. My name is Elizabeth Cameron. I am an SAP consultant with Pioneer B1. And you may have seen me in a couple of the other webinars that we've held before. With me today is Oren Tabib. He's the CEO of Pioneer B1. And we're going to be reviewing the budget setup in SAP Business One today.
Yes, thank you, Beth. And like all our training webinars, this webinar is recorded, so it will be available on our website in about a week from now.
Wonderful. So today our objective is to provide you, the SAP Business One users, with some tools to leverage the budget functionality within SAP to give you, some more traceability within your budget and to be able to kind of more accurately manage your company's budget.
Yeah, and the idea is really to get you familiar with what the budget of SAP Business One out of the box provide and what are some of the limitations so you know if it's worth using that in your company.
Absolutely. So with that being said, today on our agenda, we are going to be reviewing how to initialize the budget, to define those budget settings within SAP, as well as what the budget scenarios are. We're going to be reviewing different budget distribution methods out of the box and custom. We are going to show you how to copy budget scenarios as well as import them. We're also going to be reviewing some of the additional reporting that SAP provides once the budget has been initialized, so some of that extra budget reporting. We're also going to give you a few tips or things to be aware of, different special cases having to do with the budget. And as always, we are going to provide you with some supplementary documentation to help you, fully or maybe more fully understand the budget, things like that. And then, of course, at the end, we're going to have our, save a little bit of time for Q&A. If you do have questions throughout the session, feel free to put them in the chat and we'll answer them as they come in. But you're also more than welcome to save your questions at the end and we can answer them at that time as well. So with that being said, before we start, are there any questions? All right, wonderful. So first we're going to be starting with the very basic budget initialization and defining those settings. So we'll go right into, we're going to dive right into SAP with this one. I'm going to pull that over. Sorry about that. So we're going to dive right into SAP. Now to initialize the budget here, we'll go into our administration module, go into our system initialization and general settings. And you can see here we have a budget tab on our general settings. So this checkbox here is very simple. That checkbox there is going to initialize the budget for your company. And then below, you'll see that we have a few options here regarding deviations from the budget and how to handle those deviations. So right now we have it set up with a warning. Essentially, these options tell you if you're going to be submitting a transaction in the system that's going to cause you to deviate or exceed the budget that you've set for that GL account, this tells the system how to handle that. So either we can block it, we can just provide a warning to the user, or we can proceed with the transaction without a warning. This also allows you to determine whether you want these settings to apply for the annual budget or for the monthly budget. And then additionally, as you can see on the bottom, this gives you some flexibility. These options here give you some flexibility to determine exactly which documents you'd like to be subjected to the budget deviation. So we have purchase requests, purchase orders, goods receipt POs, and accounting. And the accounting is a little bit vague. All that that means here is that this is going to include any AP invoices, any manual journal entries, or any other transactions essentially that are hitting a GL account that's relevant to the budget. So this kind of catches all of the rest here under accounting.
Thank you, Beth. And in addition to the warning or to the block that you can define here, under the alert management, SAP provide alert management. So if you deviate from budget, it could throw a specific error to specific users, either via email or via internal message and things of that nature.
Thanks, Oren. So next, once we have this budget initialized in SAP, we're going to want to define our budget accounts. So there's a couple ways that we can do this. Right now, the way that we're going to show you is actually manually defining them. But I'll give you a couple of other options as well. So here, let's say we want to define some expense accounts for, you know, to be budget relevant here. So we'll just click on this GL account, select our account details, and then select relevant to the budget. And as you can see, this one has already been marked as relevant to the budget. Now, this is a manual way to go through and, you know, manually mark different accounts as relevant to the budget. But when you're initializing, that's probably not the route you want to go. There is an option once you first check the checkbox to initialize the budget to mark all of your P&L accounts as budget relevant. So this is the most general case, and you can just say yes, and that will go through, you know, go ahead and automatically mark your P&L accounts as budget relevant. Additionally, if after the fact you decide that there are more accounts you'd like to be marked, you can either manually go through and check those, or you can do that through the data transfer workbench as well. So now that we have kind of all of the initialization settings and all of that covered, we actually want to look into the budget. So before we go ahead and look into the budget, anybody have any questions, anything like that, feel free to add them in the chat. We'll go ahead and open this up. So here under financials, we'll want to navigate to this budget setup tab here and click on budget scenarios. We'll close all that other stuff. Now, as you can see at the top, we have the option here for fiscal year. For right now, we're in 2019. We'll go ahead and look at a 2019 budget. And I've created a budget scenario here for the main budget. Now, as you can see, there are a few, you know, few other lines here. So the budget scenarios allows us to create multiple different budget scenarios. So for instance, here we can add a row, and let's say we want to do an optimistic budget. So you guys may be familiar, it's a similar functionality here, but if you're familiar with price lists and the ability for, you know, an SAP, you can base one price list off of another price list and then mark it up by a factor, for instance, you can do the same thing with budgets. So here, let's say we want to create an optimistic budget and we'll base it on the main budget and give it a ratio of 120%. So it's going to be 20% markup from our initial budget. And we can update there. So we can create as many budget scenarios here as we'd like. In general, I've seen optimistic and pessimistic budget scenarios created, but you know, there is, they also don't have to be based on one another. So you have a lot of flexibility there. And it also gives you a lot of flexibility in reporting. So we'll look at that down the road, but we do have, you know, the ability to create these different scenarios and then run reports off of these different scenarios as well. So now that we've created, we have our main budget, we do have an optimistic budget. We're going to quickly take a look at budget distribution methods. So all of these, you know, these couple pieces in tandem are going to help us in, you know, creating and setting up our budget here. So out of the box, SAP provides us with some different budget distribution methods. So you can see here, out of the box, we have this equal budget distribution method. So what this is telling us and what this is telling SAP is that for each month in our budget, if we're going to budget yearly, each month is just going to be automatically divided from the yearly total. We also have a couple options here out of the box again for ascending and descending budget distribution methods. So we'll take a look at it as it impacts the budget, but essentially these will take a yearly budget amount and distribute that amount across the months. If you do kind of manually create your budget with amounts for every month, then you don't really need these. This is just kind of an automatic way to split your monthly total. And the use of these, now you can also create custom budget distribution methods. So it helps a lot for companies who are impacted by seasonality or seasonability. So for instance, if you have some big events in June and some big events in December, you can, select different accounts to follow these distribution methods that have special distribution for you. So now that we've got a couple of these different pieces, we want to take a look at the actual budget within SAP. So if you see here under our budget setup, we've looked at these budget scenarios, so the different budgets that you can create, as well as these budget distribution methods here, how you can distribute your budget along the different months of the year. And so now finally, we can see how these kind of add up to our full budget. So here, this box over to the right, this is going to kind of help you in narrowing down if you just want to see the budget for different drawers. You can select those here or deselect those. For right now, we're going to show you the full budget that we have set up. Here as well, you can select your budget scenario. So now you'll see these. This list is going to show you all of the budgets that are defined in the system. For us, we want to look at this main budget here for 2019. You'll also see our optimistic budget here. So for now, we'll open up this main budget. And you can see here, we have some sales revenue accounts, some sales revenue, domestic and freight accounts that we've budgeted for, as well as some expense accounts here. So this is what your budget is going to look like. You can also toggle up here on the left. So this is saying display accounts with no budget. So for instance, you'll see the sales rebates account doesn't have an amount budgeted for the account, but it is marked as budget relevant. So in this case, it's going to pull in this budget scenario. Now, if we don't want to see that, we can toggle this off and say, no, we only want to see accounts with a budget. So any questions so far as we're looking at this?
Just one note, Elizabeth, as you could see, the method is can be defined for each account separately. So you could have one method that will distribute that budget amount across the months in an equal way, but maybe some other accounts are going to be a little bit different or distributed differently. So that could be defined actually per account.
Yeah, absolutely. And from here, you can drill back down into those distribution methods. We can also go ahead and change any of these. So we can put this, say, in ascending order. And then another kind of little tip as you're going here, this is showing you our yearly budget. But we can go ahead and double click here on the header, and it's going to give you your budget item details. So that's going to give you all of your monthly budget breakdown. So in this case, we specified this now as an ascending budget distribution method. So it's calculating our monthly based on that method. So another thing, let's see. So this one we've created manually. We can do, we can import them, via DTW as well, or create them manually depending on kind of the robustness of your budget. But there are some other options for how to create these budgets that are really neat. So for instance, we've already created this optimistic budget here that's based off of the main budget. So that's one way to kind of create a budget really easily based off of another one. If we look at this optimistic budget, we can open it up, see that the values are, you know, 20% larger than what we had created in our main budget. So that is one way to kind of, you know, base one budget off of another budget and create that different budget scenario. Another option here, so we'll add a row, we'll create another budget scenario. And we'll call it copy budget. So now if we look at this copy budget, we just created it. It'll show up on our list here, but it doesn't have any values in it and it doesn't have any accounts in it as well. I mean, we can display these accounts, but none of them are budgeted. So we'll show you one way here to copy this. So if we click down here, we have this highlighted and we click copy scenario. So this allows us, it's telling us this is our original data database, our destination data database. So it's all from within the same database, but we have the option here to either take one of our previous year budgets or one of our previous year's actual balances and copy that over to the current budget that we're trying to budget for. So I think a lot of times this actual balance is a really powerful feature. So, you know, say that you budgeted last year and it was your first time ever using budgets in SAP and maybe didn't have an accurate budget. So what you can do is just take the actual balances from last year and copy that over into, say, your new budget for this year. So let's see, I'm going to take actual balances from 2006. This is a test database, so we'll probably have more data from the older years. So we'll take that actual balance and copy it over to this copy budget. We just click execute. You see on the bottom left that we do have a success message there. So then we can just close out of this window. And now once we open up our budget, this copy budget again, we can see, so not as much here, maybe not as much in our 2006 actuals as I had thought, but it will copy over any of that information. And there's another way, another similar to how we just copied over from actuals, we can do that same, you know, use that same method and copy over from one of our budgets. So here, let's say we'll copy our optimistic budget and we'll just overwrite there. We'll say yes. There we go. Now it's copied over and I suspect we have a little bit more data in that one. So now we've copied over that budget scenario. So that's a couple ways to copy scenarios from one way to the other. There also is a method for importing scenarios. So before we move on, Oren, did you have anything to add for copying or?
No.
Okay. Beautiful. So we'll go ahead and import a scenario. So we'll call this imported scenario. Update that creates this budget scenario. And now we see this little option over here to import the scenario. So what this allows us to do is actually take a budget from another company and import it into a new company or, you know, our current company here. So for a lot of you that maybe run multiple databases, things like that, this is going to be really useful for you. So this allows you to choose a company. Here we'll choose this other one. Make sure you have a user in it so you can log into the company and say okay, and it'll confirm up here that you are taking the data from this other company. And then just like in the copy scenarios option, we have the ability to copy any budgets that were created in that other company as well as any actual balances. So, and you may notice here that we only are seeing actual balances for a few years. So that is one caveat of being able to create these budget scenarios or import or copy is that if you do want to copy an actual balance into a budget scenario, the only actual balances that are going to pull are from budgeted years. So if you do, in this case, we don't have a budget for 2018 in that other database, so we're not seeing an actual balance available to select from, you can just create a blank budget scenario for that year and be able to pull in that actual balance. So kind of a little bit of a workaround there, but it allows you to pull that actual balance. So we'll pull actual balances from our other database, and then we will pull that into our imported scenario here and execute.
Yeah, and you can use that, for example, if you would like to have a sandbox and import all the budget and test and things of that nature. And then as you are ready to move it to your actual production database, you could just do that import, basically.
Absolutely. So those are the few ways either to copy your budget scenarios, import your budget scenarios, you know, different options like that. So any questions on creating budget scenarios, copying them, anything like that?
No questions, but maybe one addition to creating a budget scenario. If you have your budgets in Excel and you want to bring them into SAP, you could also use DTW to bring those amounts in addition to those options that Beth showed.
Beautiful. So as we go on, we just want to show you a few here under the financial reports. Once you initialize this budget, you will also have these additional budget reports created. So we can open those up. The first one that's probably our main, you know, one of our main or most important reports that's added here is this budget report. So up here under scenario, this is where creating those different budget scenarios gives you a lot of flexibility. So you're able to, for instance, this budget report is going to pull in your budgeted amounts and compare them against your actuals. So in this case, you can see, you know, maybe if you are in line with your main budget, in line with an optimistic budget, maybe a pessimistic budget, and see, you know, your over-unders there. So we'll go with the main budget first off. We can also, or we also have the ability here to run the report and split up, you know, our analysis annually, quarterly, or monthly. So first, we'll just go ahead and run it annually. Again, we have this option here, as you'll see on, you know, as you may be familiar with a lot of financial reports, this option to kind of filter which accounts you want to pull in. And then down here, the options to choose different years, which will update the budget scenarios that are available to you. So here for 2018, we just have the main budget, things like that. So that'll kind of, you know, change this up here, and then also allows you to run it monthly for a span of months or for the entire year. So we'll go ahead and execute this. Now it comes up just by default with these natural accounts, these header accounts, but if we go down in our case to level 4, we have all of our GL accounts and details at this level. So as you can see, we ran it annually, so we're just getting our annual report here, and we're able to see budgeted values versus our actuals for those accounts, as well as the dollar difference and then the difference in percentage as well. So, and as I mentioned, we are able to run, you know, all of those reports in the different scenarios. And then we also have this monthly view. So we can just see from, you know, a very high level, if we want to check out our revenue and expenses, we can look, and we have the same analysis for our total with budgets versus the actuals, difference in dollar amount and difference in percentage. And then we have that data available also monthly as you go. So you're able to see, you know, a lot of different views on if you're hitting your budget, exceeding, all that good kind of stuff.
Now, if you mark the whole year, it will show you the budget for the whole year. But if you want to see what is the budgeted amount, for example, until the end of August, the table below, you will be able to choose up until August, and that will show you the relevant budget until August, and you will be able to compare it to your actuals.
Wonderful. So the other ones that you can see here, we have our balance sheet budget report, we have our trial balance budget report, and then we also have our profit and loss statement budget report. So in general, probably the two most important or two most generally used reports would be this budget report and our profit and loss statement here. We can take a look at these other two. I think they're probably not as widely used, but they're still they still follow the same kind of layout as a lot of our financial reports. So they are fairly intuitive to use. So we'll go ahead and just with the default settings, we can review those really quick. So the same thing as we saw on our budget report, we are able to select different months here or select the entire year. Again, we have the option, pull that back up. So again, we have the option to select the scenario. We can also, again, select annual, quarterly, or monthly for the report view. And then this one gives us some options as well to, you know, maybe only show the budget relevant accounts or maybe show, make sure we include accounts with a balance of zero, things like that. So we can go ahead and run that. And you'll see assets, liabilities, equity, your standard balance sheet. But we do have, you know, if any of these accounts are budgeted, we do have the budgeted amount there as well for you to compare. So this helps a lot in this case. So for instance, your inventory accounts, if you have a certain level that you don't want, you know, the value, your value in inventory to exceed a certain level, this can be really helpful for that. So that gives you a little peek at our balance sheet budget report there. And again, a really similar view for our trial balance budget report here as well. We can go ahead and run that and open it up. And now you are able to see here any of your budgeted amounts for those accounts. We've budgeted a lot more down here in the expenses for this webinar, but you are able to see again budgets versus actuals, difference in amount and difference in percentage. So a lot of these budget reports are going to be, you know, even if you're just new to using the budget, a lot of them can be really familiar to you if you've run financial reports in SAP before. And then we can go down here and run our profit and loss statement. So very similar setup, just like the other ones. We'll click OK, go ahead and run it. And then as you'd expect, we see our budgets, our actuals, difference and difference in percent. Oops. So any questions relating to budget reports, anything like that? All right. Perfect. So the next thing that we wanted to move on to were a few tips and tricks or special scenarios or things to be aware of in relation to the budget. So let's go ahead and open this budget back up. We'll open up our main budget for 2019. And we can see here, I've already set one up, so I'm going to go ahead and remove this. So we can see this parent account value here and a percentage. So this is something that's available to you for calculation purposes. So for instance, for sales revenues, let's say that we expect our sales revenues for freight to be 25% of domestic. That's what we're budgeting for. That's what we're expecting. So we'll go ahead and choose the sales revenues domestic as our parent account. And we'll say this freight revenues account, we're going to budget as 25% of that account. Actually, it looks like I did not select the right account, so just one moment. There we are. Perfect. So, and it automatically calculates here our, our budgeted amount based on the parent account. So in this case, it's not going to deduct this calculated amount here. It's not going to deduct that from the parent account. So this is strictly used as a calculation tool. Again, not going to deduct from the parent account. So we'll say yes, and our budget's updated, our actuals are updated, and we're all set there. And then also, as you can see here on the right, we are, budgeting does support cost accounting. So if you do have cost accounting deployed in your database, you can budget per dimension here. So we'll choose product line, and you can see that for some of these, we already have some different amounts budgeted. We can also here, if we want to add a cost center or add a budget per cost center here, we can do that simply just right click here on the GL and click add cost center. We'll choose that and then budget accordingly. All right, any questions at this time? So now there is just one other small special case that we wanted to mention in relation to the budget. So for balance sheet accounts, it does support, SAP does support budgeting for all accounts. So, you know, in any of your drawers, any accounts, you can create a budget for it. Although in the initialization, generally our P&L accounts are the ones that are most commonly budgeted for. So as you're initializing it, SAP will ask you if you do want to automatically initialize all of the P&L accounts for the budget, but it won't ask you for balance sheet. So if you do want to budget for any of those balance sheet accounts, you will have to kind of create those or, you know, tick those boxes manually or through a DTW.
Yes, thank you, Beth. I think, yeah, traditionally, most companies are really using P&L accounts for budget for expenses as well as, you know, revenue targets. But I think it's really beneficial also to define a budget to some of the balance sheet accounts so you can get those alerts if you exceed it. For example, if you want your accounts receivable not to hit a specific number or to get an alert when you hit a specific number, you could do that, as well as it works to define that for, you know, different inventory accounts. So you maintain your cash sitting in the warehouse under a specific amount.
Thanks, Oren. So other than this, that was it. Seems like a little bit of a short webinar here, a short kind of finished a little quickly, but essentially from here, we just wanted to provide you some documentation. So first of all, Pioneer, so use us as a resource if you have any questions. Also on our website, we do have this how-to guide. So
our handy dandy website here. If you go to our resources and click on how to guides, this is going to bring you to the knowledge base on our website. And we do have a document from SAP on how to manage budgets. We also will be releasing this webinar as well as the PowerPoint for the webinar in our blog. So feel free to check out our blog here on our website. Additionally, once you have this PowerPoint and it's released on our blog, you will have just have the link for our tips and tricks page as well as our YouTube page. So those are always great resources. We're always putting out different tips and tricks there. And then additionally, if you have any questions and through us and through the webinar and all of that, if you can't find anything, Google is always a resource. So lots of documentation there. So I guess at this time, does anybody have any questions, any special scenarios, any feedback that they'd like to share?
Elizabeth, can you bring maybe the presentation? We'll summarize what we went through, and we're going to wrap it up unless if there are any questions. So what we went through is really starting what you need to do to have a budget from A to Z, how to define a new budget, how to define those accounts, how to use the distribution methods and different types of methods, reporting behind all of that and what it will give you, as well as if you want to learn more, what are those documentation. So I see there are no questions. So thank you everyone for joining us today. Thank you, Beth, for leading this great session. And we'll see you again in the webinar next month. Have a great long weekend, everyone.